sacrifices and low purposes.
Alright, there's a few different ways to do a slide-by. My favorite one is just a classic ear-to-ear tie-up.
I'll never actually say tie-up ear-to-ear, because I don't...
Once you get to higher levels, there's really not much you can pick. But they're still in high school, a lot of guys still will love to get right in here, especially tired, third period. People love to hang out here. So, one of the things I do is when I'm here, and this hand is ear-to-ear, I just take this step in, I take my forearm to the back of their tricep, I look away, and I pull this in tight, keep it here, it's almost like a JI position, you can go straight to it, or I get hip to hip, knee to knee, and bring them right down here, just to finish. So, it's a real, I love slide by, I had a knee injury, and I actually got to stay, because it's the only move I could do, I couldn't really do any leg attacks, so this has become a good move with people who tie up a lot. So again, I'm here tied up, I step, pop that off, I pull this in tight, then again, if there's somebody who likes the JI, you go right to the JI, or right to this tight waist. You don't want to let this arm go, because now you're in a position here, and they can just get wrist control, break right out, and you just gave up an easy place. So again, if I tie up, I hit this here, I keep this tight, I'm going to come into this waist, or this leg, for the JI. So again, tight waist, I'll step hip to hip, bring him down, and I got my two. Jeremy, you want to show the JI off a bit? Yeah. Is that right? Grab, show him off. So, just another finish to it. Over this tricep and you pull it as well. I've never been able to do that one. It doesn't feel comfortable. My arm feels weird. I have no idea. It's just not for me. I have seen it successfully hit though. I'm a good wrestler, so it's not something that like doesn't work. It just wasn't for me personally. Find a slide by that works in wrestling, because there's gonna be times where guys are gonna just come right here, or whether you're coming inside or you're here. Either way, you need to have an upper body attack, and that way, you know, you want to be the guy when somebody's wrestling, don't tie up with them, don't tie up with them. You want to be that guy. You don't want to be the guy that, oh, I can't even tie up, and then you're limiting yourself. If a guy's scared to tie up with you, you know how much easier it is to know that they're just going to shoot on you, and you have to just defend the shot versus defend upper body, lower body. So again, be able to wrestle up here, you know, again, I may step in, pin this, looking away, popping this right off, pulling this in tight. And again, you go JI. A tight waist, stepping this leg out just a little bit so I can just bring him right down. I don't want to fall straight down. I don't want to give him an opportunity to just grab my leg from here. When I come here, I don't want to, you know, there's all sorts of weird stuff. You just grab it. I really want to still keep a wide base and bring him down smoothly. Does that all make sense?
Yeah. Cool.
Okay, so again, make sure this technique is right. If you want to do it to the other side, very few people tie up this way. But you can do it both sides, the better. It just becomes understanding how to mimic it. You know, I step, go, I step, go. This forearm to tricep, I can like pretend like I'm looking at a watch the whole way. There's a lot of different, but the technique on this, if you get the technique proper, it's an amazing move. College, high school, state, nationals, I hit it, I love it. I mean, it's something like my old coach at Oak Creek will sometimes will wrestle, and like, oh, I knew you had that, and still don't see it coming. So it's a great move to have in the arsenal. It's a great, great, great move. If I coach you, you have to have it in your arsenal. That's just how it is. So there it is. Any more to see again? Are we good? too.